Okay, good afternoon everyone. Assalamualaikum. We start the week 13. We will discuss the advanced intelligence system. This will continue the previous chapter 11. We will discuss more practically, maybe for the pandemic situation and online course, we will use the Google Colab. This is the learning objective. First, the neural networks. And then we also discuss genetic algorithm and fuzzy logic in briefing. Only the general idea. You also can open your ebook in chapter 12. Here you can see in the beginning there is a success story and using the neural network and decision support in credit allowance credit loans in 1994, and then this is the vision system. There is a second module, training, lead, solicitation, underwriting, closing, and etc. And the result is the vision system can cut down the waiting time, so more quick than manual system. And then we will discuss the machine learning. So we already know that this is, for example, the AI, artificial intelligence. And in the artificial intelligence, there is some problem, for example, the optimization to find the optimum composition, and also maybe there is another machine learning. This is machine learning different with the optimization. Machine learning using the data to give the model in order the model can train using the data, and then after training the model will be have the intelligence. And then if there is one input using the train model will give the prediction. So this is the machine learning usually is prediction. Maybe there is another clustering, clustering. This is different with model machine learning. In clustering, we only create the cluster from the data. We, for example, 2 cluster, 3 cluster, 4 cluster, and etc. Or the data train is usually unsupervised, and machine learning is usually supervised. In machine learning, there is a lot of method. One method is using neural network, and then they continue become the deep learning or deep neural network, deep learning. So this is the deep neural network ya. Or deep learning ya. Or deep neural network ya. And also another branch, and we call it the computational intelligence, or we call it CI, yeah, computational intelligence. Here, there is a fuzzy here, fuzzy, and also neural network is also inside the computational intelligence. So CI is a part of AI, but they focus on soft computing. If you search in Google, soft computing will explain the computational, but there is some uncertainty. There is the data that built not some missing value and etc. Yeah, so they use the soft computing and more robust yeah than the hard computing. For example, if the input maybe missing one input, the soft computing can still running yeah, the model or the system. Okay, first we go to the machine learning. They use the historical examples. If you open again the last week material, the knowledge is using the rule ya. The rule is we create the rule, and then we try to use another input and then create the prediction. But in machine learning, we do not create the rule, but the rule is automatically get generate using the historical example. Yeah. So the historical example should have the labels of or the target or for example, if you want to create the machine learning that can analyze the credit loans, we use the historical example. At least there is two class ya. There is the data that rejected and also the data that accepted. We of course we cannot learn, machine cannot learn if there is only one, for example only the accepted historical data ya. So and also the historical data is usually should be balanced ya. For example, there is a 100 rejected and also 100 accepted. Because if, for example, 100 accepted and only 10 rejected, this is the system will not have the good learning. Maybe different from human learn ya, yeah? Because this is only based on data. Using the symbol, for example in vision ya, computer vision image. Then this is the method. There is two kind. Supervised learning and then unsupervised learning. For the supervised learning, the previous or historical data should have the label. For example, for the scholarship decision, If we want to train the model using the previous, so we have to gather to prepare with the data of student have scholarship and student that rejected. So this is a supervised learning. But if we don't have the previous data, usually we use the unsupervised learning with unknown outcomes. Or for example, if you want to create the scholarship machine, decision for scholarship, we have not the previous data about the student have scholarship or rejected. So maybe it is the first time we can use the clustering. For example, we use the current data and then the machine automatically cluster the data, and then we analyze the cluster. Oh, the cluster one is the for example rich people, rich student, and another cluster maybe poor student, and there is another cluster again, for example the student rich student have the good performance, GPA, for example, this clever student, and then we try to set the cluster that contain the student with poor student but have the good academic performance. So this is maybe become the candidate for the scholarship. This is unsupervised learning. And another method is the cache reasoning. This is the inductive. This is based on cache for decision making. This is effective when like previous last week, rule based reasoning is not cannot give the good prediction. So we use the cache based for cache. This is the ossified paradigmatic stories. You can learn more deep about rule based because this is usually try to find the similar case for the prediction. For example, in COVID-19, we do not have the previous data and previous knowledge, but we can searching the similar case, for example, in pandemic in 90s or 80s, forget them. And then we try to use previous case to prediction the current case. Maybe from stories, from paradigmatic, ossified, and etc. This is the case. Case we have to classify it, repetitive or not. There is a unique, and then we use the method. This is induction, indexing, introduction, indexing, and this is the knowledge. Role, experience, etc. And then this is the process to cache based reasoning. This is similar for SDLC, from the beginning analysis, and then testing, and then implementation, or this is a prepare and test, and there is a cycles or SDLC. This is the flowchart. You can see C similarity, we have to use some similarity calculation for the memory or the previous data. And then if the most similar case will become the solution. Similar case, and also maybe there is some modification from previous case following the current, maybe some date, time, etc. should be fixed. And then this is the proposed solution, and then we have to check it. And then this is the conclusion, we have to give the explanation to the user. And the success factor is the you have to learn the business, and then also the business objective. Knowledge should directly support the user, appropriate design, return of investment, and etc. This is the success factor of the case reasoning. And then we continue to the, where is it? Neural network. This is the, what is the neural network? This is the human brain. The human brain contain 150 billion neurons, and then group into some layer or network, and there is axon, and also this is the input dendrite, and then if this is the input, and then there is soma and cleus that create the signal continue or not. If this is the decide after learning, this is continue. So this is the input signal we will continue to next cell. Then the composition of cell can create the memory, a decision, and etc. And this is the neural network. In the beginning, there is an artificial neural network, but today we delete the artificial. If there is a neural network, it means that this is the artificial. And this is the mimic brain function, only the analogy. This is not accurate model, only the analogy based on the learning. For example, you see the picture in your brain, there is you consider the there is an image, and you see only the analogy. You can have the same interpretation with your friend that see the same image. This is only the analogy. Because we do not need the exact number, and only the composition of network. Oh, of course, in this, the input signal will be modified before continue to the next neuron. This is the processing. There is weight and also by bias, but it is the weight is the most important. And then we have the transfer function. This is the relation between input and output. For example, if the transfer function we transfer, for example, this is the linear, and then this is for sigmoid, or this is step, yeah. But for deep learning, usually using the linear. It means that if the neuron consider this is important, they will keep the weight maximum and then they continue traces. But if the new neuron consider this is not important, so this is zero. Just according to this, and this is the architecture, a lot of architecture for neural network. Until today, the scientists do not exactly understand the architecture of our brain, but they believe that our brain is not linear, they parallel processing. And but for the artificial neural network, we have to give some abstraction, or not exactly, but only pendekatan, yeah, or similar, but not exactly similar with our brain. But looks like, yeah. For example, the feedback back propagation, there is a link for input to output. This is continue from similar with the forward chaining from the input and go to output. Another architecture is associated memory. We use the correlation, just the input data where the stored information. And also there is a recurrent structure, and this is different with the feedforward because the output signal will back to the input, and this is a recurrent. This is there is some looping. So, yeah, for example, this is input and then go to the output, but sometimes they go back to here. Yeah? This is the recurrent neural network. This is the learning. How to max the set up the model. We have to create the weights that give the exact or correct output. This is the weight should be. Also, maybe for unsupervised, only find the similarity. There is a rule: if different cluster should have the what is mean, yeah? Similarity and similar to the grup yang sama itu cenderung memiliki similarity tinggi, grup yang berbeda cenderung memiliki perbedaan. Jadi there is one calculation, ya. For example, this is one group, this is another group, this is the same group should have the more similarity than other group, ya. Yeah. There is some center of cluster ya. Yeah, for example, it's a center of cluster. If this is should have the more near than to the other center. For example, this is the star cluster. They should have the near compare with this. This is the algorithm of clustering. How to the laptop? First, we have to collect the data. More data will be better. Of course, the current we have the big data, so we have to grab the as much as possible. And then divide into training and testing. For example, we have 1,000 data. Usually 80% is for training and 20% is for testing. Training, the remaining 20% will be prepared for testing. Testing after the learning to check the accuracy. If the, for example, 90% accuracy, the model is already ready to implement. But the usually there is some basic there is a training, validation, and the final is testing. For example, we have 1,000 data, maybe the 100 is for training and this is for testing, and then validation, and then we after create the model, and for example the accuracy is already good, 90%, for example, and then we go to the source of data again and collect the newer version of data. For example, this is 110, and then we test with the new version of the data, and we check again. For example, akurasinya is 40, 80%, for example. Of course, but usually in skripsi or bachelor thesis, usually only use this without the test data or testing and testing, because usually we do not need to go back to the industry again, the case study again, to collect the new data. Usually is we only one group of data, and then we only this data to be process. But for example, the genos, the automatic COVID-19 test, usually they use newer data again and again to training the machine in order to have the better intelligence. And this is the genetic algorithm. This is the optimization, genetic algorithm, part of AI, and they mimics the evolution of Darwin, makhluk hidup or organism. And then they should calculate the fitness, and then the worst become dead or punah ya, instinct, and then the good organism individual will crossover or mutation and then create the new version and fitness, calculate again the fitness, And then there is a selection again, and then we this is the process will do until there is no improvement. This is the flowchart. Okay, we continue to fuzzy logic. Okay, but maybe this is some illustration for the good genetic algorithm. For example, we have okay, it's difficult to explain ya genetic algorithm. Or I will give some material. Maybe this is the famous source. I think there is all have been removed. Maybe use some genetic algorithm. You can. Oh, this is not. Maybe here. Must be not found. Okay, we continue again to the fuzzy. Fuzzy logic is using the fuzzy set. Similar with human perception. It continues and there is a step fuzzification. For example, if we use the thermometer for our body yang for checking the fever. Fuzzification means that we convert the, for example, 76 degree into some linguistic. For example, hot, medium, or fever, and etc. Using the, and then there is a defuzzification. It is conversion from the linguistic hot and cold and etc. into the number again. This is why we use the fuzzification, because we have to create the fuzzy. It means that we still can calculate even there is a non-accurate or there is some uncertainty in the input. This is the Google Collab for fuzzy. I will share to you, can try to run using the your browser. I have copy paste in chatting, Zoom chat, and you can run this. We use the library from scikit-fuzzy, and then first we have to download some megabyte to set up, because we use only Google Collab, so it's easily, because we don't need to import another, and then we import the third. And in this is the simple case, there is some service, for example in restaurant or etc. There is a quality delicious food and etc. And then there is a service for the people, yeah. And then we give the decision, yeah, giving the tip or not, giving the small tip or high tip, etc. According to these two input, yeah. So we have the two input here. And then there is some term that you have, if you interest to this subject, you can searching or learn from the internet. The term, for example, what is the membership function? What is fuzzification, depuzzification, and how to calculate the fuzzy, and etc. This is the for tip, low, yeah, low, and this is the medium. Actually, this is the triangle function. For example, for quality, you see 0, and where is 11? Usually, this is not closed again. And we want to view the average quality, yeah. For example, this is the average, or for example, no, can check the log, for example. Yeah, where is the problem? Oh, quality. The quality is option a poor, average, or good, or poor. For example, poor. Yeah. Poor. It should be in the left. This is the poor. Yeah. You see, we do not exact number of the poor. Yeah, because this is we using fuzzy. If we I will give the analogy for the press, yeah. For fuzzy, Jokowi is win 60%. But in fuzzy, we can also say the Prabowo win 40%. So because using we use the fuzzy, not exactly Jokowi win. Prabowo win, but in fuzzy we have to use the fuzzy set. Jokowi win 60%. Also we can say that Jokowi is kalah, ya, 40%, ya, loss, ya, Jokowi lost 40%, or Prabowo lost 60%, Prabowo win 40%. So this is similar with poor, average. Average is in the middle here. So it's average. And this good is this here, good. This is the how the fuzzy work. But maybe this is only linear, but some we can use another here like this. For example, here this is another kind of more what is it? Sigmoid function, yeah, sigmoid function. This is linear function. But okay, this is more easy to calculate. This is the service for average and etc. And then this is the tip. We give the high tip here, or medium or low. This is how the sample. How we create the rule? This is similar with your previous assignment. Yeah. Rule of one, for example, this is similar with if. Yeah. If the quality is poor, end of or. Yeah. This is, I think this is or. Yeah. Or service is poor, so give the tip low. If the service is average, give tip medium. But if the service is good, quality is good, give the high tip. This is the similar with our previous. This is only for rule appearance. This is the some implementation. Control system rule one is not defined. Rule one, oh, this is not running yet. And then we continue this. This is rule. This is the tipping, and then we give the sample. For example, the quality is 6.5, and the service is 9. And then we compute the tip, the tipping. Yeah. And then we, this is the result. The this decision is the high tip, I think. For example, the service is low. For example, what is the maybe 1.8. And then the result is so we will give the medium, yeah. Medium tip here. If you see, the location is this is middle. Oh, we just keep the extreme. For example, both of quality and service is bad, and then we will give the result. This is the result. This is the number here is after the fuzzification process. Yeah. This is the picture is fuzzy, and then after we calculate here, we have to give number again. 24%. 0 to is medium, or we this is based on the service, ya, yeah. From 0 to actually from 0 to 11, ya, yeah. So for example, we give the maximum number 11, but usually in fuzzy we do not have the maximum, ya, yeah. Even with the maximum, yeah, the result is still here, but this is the region of if you see, this is the region of ini high tip, ya, yeah. Yeah. This is the high tip. If this is 5.5, we see the region is in the middle, I think. Yes, this is the medium, and for bad quality and service, the area is in the low tip. But of course, there is calculation here. Yeah, and this is the we have to calculate the center of gravity of this block. Yeah, and this is the result is here. The maybe 8, yeah. This is the 8.1 here. Okay, try by yourself. I have shared the link of the Fuzzy. It easily we can you can only use your browser even with your smartphone without installing the MATLAB or Python etc. Okay, I think enough for this session. I will start to capture your attendance. I will give you one assignment. Simply, you only just draw the interface input, and there is, for example, some button for process and etc. Okay, I have captured your attendance. Thank you very much. Good night. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.